Good afternoon, team. My name is Tendai, based in South Africa, Johannesburg. I am a Nebosha lead tutor, and today I'm going to take you through one of the section of Nebosha papers, that is the practical side. So if you are watching this video, consider yourself lucky if you are a Nebosh student, an aspiring Nebosh student, somebody who is rewriting the practical, somebody who is writing the practical for the first time. Consider yourself lucky, because at the end of the day, you are going to see how important this session is. So what are we going to do today? Today we are going to focus on the introduction. Introduction is one of the section under the report writing. You gotta remember, on the practical side, we have got the observation and the report writing, where after doing the observation, you are supposed to write what? You are supposed to write a report. And according to the Nebosh requirement, there has to be a logical progression. That is, the report writing has to follow from the observation. The two has to marry. If there is no relationship between the two, then it then becomes a cause of, you know, concern. So under the report writing, we have got sections that are there. That is, we've got the introduction, the executive summary, the main finding, the conclusion, and the recommendation. Get it? So under the introduction, what are we supposed to do? What are we supposed to write? And it is marked out of how many marks. Most students, they write their practical without knowing the mark allocation. The introduction is marked out of 5, and you are supposed to get 5. You know, this section is actually one of the easiest section under the report, you know, writing. So what are we expected to do? We are supposed to give a clear picture of the description of the area, give a detailed description of the area, as well as the activities involved into that area where you did your inspection. You get it? So what are we saying? We are saying we need to understand, number one, the why you conducted the inspection. Tell us why you conducted the inspection. You get it? Number two, the when. We need, remember, there's the issue of validity. When did you conduct the inspection? Tell us the date when the inspection was conducted. The marker, the reader, also want to check the validity of this inspection or observation report. Get it? So we need you to give us the date when this inspection was conducted. The where part. Where? Obviously, you cannot complete your observation without telling us the way where that inspection was carried out, or where you conducted that inspection. So tell us, give us the location. Where exactly did you conduct this inspection? Obviously, you cannot say you conducted the inspection in the blues, no way. We need to know where that inspection was carried out. You get it? Scope of work. Give us the scope of work. You get it? Give us, you know, you cannot write your observation, you complete your report, without give us the scope of work. Give us what exactly was happening there. Was it building of a school, a bridge, a hospital? What exactly was happening? You get it? So you need to give us the scope of work. After giving us the scope of work, give us the major activities involved. Major activities. The major activities involved. Though most people, they tend to either put the scope of work leaving the major activities, or the major activities leaving the scope of work. It's actually simple. Just tell us, for example, The scope of work, for example, construction of a primary school and the major activities involved was probably clearing of the land, excavation, brickwork, you know, all those things. So you need to tell us the major activities. So on the project that you conducted the inspection, you know the scope of work. The major activities are not the same. They vary depending with the scope of work. So it is up to you to tell us the major activities. So it is very important to understand this word major. We are not saying give us all the activities. Give us the major activities involved in that project where you carried the inspection. And then thereafter, we then go on to equipment. Or machinery. Obviously, there were machines or tools or equipment that were also used. Focus on the major, otherwise we'll end up writing all the machinery there. Just give us a brief of the of some of the equipment that were also involved into, you know, into that project. It is very important. Oh, number of employees. Number of employees. We need to know the employees that were there, that were employed there on this project. Tell us, again, the number of employees that were there on this project. Were they 30? Were they 100? Were they 200? Just give us an indication. You can also go further by also highlighting their experience or their competency. To say probably the employees that were there, they were maybe selected based on their, you know, competence or experience. We were helping the engineers, the ship practitioners, and the other people. So it is actually very important to also, you know, highlight also the number of the employees on that project. Contractor. In this case, who was managing this project? Was it a principal contractor with the other subcontractors? Or there was no, it's you, it was only your own project. You get it? Give us an indication of who indeed was actually managing this project. Who was the principal contractor? You get it? So in other words, we need you to demonstrate to the reader, to the marker, your understanding of the Nebosch theory. Your understanding of the Nebosch theory will assist you in how you package, you know, this report. So as I indicated earlier on, this part is out of 5 marks, but these points are more than 5 marks. So there's no way where you can actually say, I failed to come up with 5 points. But I'm not saying only write 5 points. Write more than 5 points. In case one of the points has not been clearly outlined, you still have a backup of points. You get it? So it is actually very important to make sure that you exhaust all the points. Make sure that when you are writing this section, you need to be guided by the Nebosch requirement. Do not just write things haphazardly. At least have an understanding, a clear picture of what the Nebosch requirements want in as far as the introduction is actually, you know, concerned. Surely, if you put these things, you will not fail to actually earn higher marks on this section. Remember, like what I've indicated, this section is actually one of the easiest sections where you need to make sure that you earn higher marks. Not even higher marks, but to take all the 5, you know, marks on this section. So, team, it's now up to you to make sure that you put these things in a manner that will attract, you know, higher marks. You get it? So, thank you so much for your time of, you know, watching this video. And if you want to, you know, receive, you know, notification of more videos to come, please just press the, you know, subscribe button so that you can receive more information. So in our next video, we are going to be, you know, talking on the next section of the Nebosch, you know, report writing. Remember, Other videos are about, you know, NABOSH diploma. So if you are, you know, if you like it, then you know that everything is going to be fine for you. Once again, thank you so much for your time, for watching this video. See you again.